Hi there, I'm Logan Medish, and this is High Caliber History. One of the great things about being a gun guy is the amount of history that's out there in the form of books. Chances are, if you're a gun guy, you're probably also a book guy. And so we're gonna do a book review here. This is a title you may not be familiar with. It's called Firearms Curiosa by Lewis Winant. It came out in the 1950s. And if you're looking for a single volume that covers the weird and wacky and wonderful, this book is it. There's some really interesting stuff. Even on the cover of the book, we've got guns that are designed to be disguised as pocket watches. You've got stuff with multiple cylinders on revolvers that are superposed, firing one in front of the other. He covers a wide variety of things in here. We've got combination guns, miniature guns, two-barrel revolvers, two-cylinder revolvers, squeezers, knuckle dusters, alarm guns, trap guns, knife pistols, cane guns, other disguised guns, superposed loads, turret guns, chain guns, and then miscellaneous and fancy free. He covers a little bit of everything in here. So if you find yourself curious about umbrella guns, they're in here. Cane guns, they're in here. Sundial guns, they're in here too. There's even a knife and fork gun, which is probably not something that I would advise ever wanting to use. But he goes over some really, really unusual things in here. Turret guns, horizontal and vertical. Little guns hidden inside of keys, guns hidden inside of cigarette cases and pocket cases, Nazi belt buckle guns, knife guns, trap guns, alarm guns, stuff that you'd see in cemeteries, triple threat knuckle dusters, brass knuckles and dagger combination pieces, and it's all very, very detailed. You know, where available to him in the 1950s, you know, he goes through and Lewis Winant mentions patent numbers, and there's patent drawings, and he'll give the history of the guns and the history of the inventors and the other individuals who were involved in there. And there are, of course, there are photographs and illustrations where possible and where available. So there's one of the umbrella guns there. And so he really does a good job going through some of the more unusual pieces. And of course, there's some stuff that you may have seen before. You know, we've got some of the palm squeezers. I've got the little all right down here, which if you've been on my blog, you've seen a blog post about that as well. And so this is definitely a book I would recommend you picking up. They got the fist guns, popular in Inglourious Bastards. You can get this book. It's not too terribly expensive. Of course, it is long out of print, but it comes in at close to 300 pages long. So it's a lot of information that you'll find in this book that you're not necessarily going to find anywhere else. So I would definitely recommend you do some searching online, find copies on eBay or Amazon. You most certainly definitely want to have this in your library. The Firearms Curiosa, the book definitely lives up to the title. So make sure to grab yourself a copy. Thanks, guys.